Okay. So the motivation is essentially why learn about the Hinnon algorithm itself. And the reason for talking about Hinnon algorithm are essentially twofold. One is because, well, history is interesting and we are trying to put things in perspective of essentially what people before us thought about this problem, people before us thought about how to solve this particular problem. The second reason for this is that it really is one of the first or perhaps the first numerical method, and using this particular simple example poses us very nicely in order to talk about these numerical methods itself. Then we took that example, we started with the initial guess of 0.5, and again we calculated the next value x equal to 0.5 plus 2 divided by 0.5, the average of that multiplied by half. And the next value, so what I have done is I have used an Excel sheet over here, and this is just a result from the Excel sheet. The first column is the iteration, number of iteration, 0th iteration essentially signifies that was the initial guess that we started off with. The initial guess we started off with was x. Over here I am writing 2 by x, and the average of these two numbers I am writing in the fourth column. The numerical method tells us essentially x is going to be the average of x and 2 divided by x, so that is the new value of x. So we have taken this particular value and put it over here. Okay. So we started with 0.5, the average of 0.5 and 2 by 0.5 is 2.25, we took that 2.25 as the next guess. Okay. So the next guess after that is going to be 2.25 and 2 divided by 2.25, we take the average of these two numbers, and the average of these two numbers happens to be 1.569. Okay. So this average is going to be the value of x at the second iteration. Okay. And we continue this over and over again until a certain point. In this particular case, I have done the Excel simulations up to iteration number 6. What we see over here is the first value was of x, the first initial guess of x was 0.5, the second initial guess was 2.25. Both these values are quite far away from the actual solution, 1.414214. Okay. The third value comes fairly close, we reach 1.569. The fourth value is even closer, 1.422, 1.414, 1.414, 1.414. In this particular example, I was interested in getting the result up to 6 digits after a decimal point, and that is why when the 6th digit after the decimal point did not change, I said I am going to be satisfied with my solution, and I take the value of x that I obtained in the 6th iteration as my solution. So this particular example has all the features essentially of the numerical techniques that we talk about. It is an iterative procedure, it is the simple, same simple equation that we apply over and over again in order to get the solution. We start with an initial guess and slowly converge to the desired solution, and we define a stopping criterion where we are going to say that the solution that we now have, we are satisfied with. Okay. So this is the way we would do the findings, the square root of 2. If we were to use a Hinnon algorithm and formalize it under the computational technique framework that we are going to use in this particular course. Now let us look at the graphical insight. What I show over here in the blue curve over here is essentially how the value of x behaves. So if I go back to the previous slide, this value of x I am plotting as the blue curve. And this value 2 divided by x I am plotting as the red curve over here. Okay. So this is the blue curve, this is the red curve defining x and 2 divided by x. The x axis is the iteration number, 0th iteration is the initial guess, first iteration, second iteration and so on. This particular x value, the x value at iteration number I is just the average of this red value and this blue value in the previous iteration. And this black line, thin black horizontal line that you see over here is the true solution of square root of 2. Okay. What you find is an interesting thing, and again this is where the history becomes very interesting, is if you want to see why perhaps if we want to go back and think about why the Babylonian people thought about this particular algorithm, is essentially if you look at x and 2 divided by x, they lie over here, they are lying on either side of this particular line. So if x is less than square root of 2, 1 by 2 by x is going to be greater than square root of 2. Over here, from this value of x, the next value of x has gone to 2.25. So the value of x now is greater than square root of 2, but value of 2 by x you will see is less than square root of 2, and you will see this pattern repeating throughout the overall values. No matter what positive value of x you choose, the value of 2 divided by x is also 1, it is also going to be positive, and second, it is going to lie on the other side of the line square root of 2. Okay. So essentially what we are doing over here is we are hoping that if we take the average of x and 2 divided by x, we will go closer and closer to square root of 2, and the reason is that the average of x and 2 divided by x always lies between the values x and 2 divided by x. Okay. And these two values will eventually converge to the desired solution. Okay. So that gives us the graphical insight behind these this Hinnon algorithm, and possibly trying to think about how or why the Babylonian people perhaps thought of this particular algorithm in order to solve this particular problem. Next, what we would do, and again I am not really going to do it in this particular module, but we will defer it to the fourth module, is we will do a Taylor series expansion and try to find out how this particular Hinnon algorithm can be derived in a rigorous manner. And I will just give you an overview of what we are going to do. Is essentially we want to find the solution x equal to square root of 2. We will square both sides and then we will be able to write x square equal to 2, and that equation we can write it out as x square minus 2 equal to 0. If we call this particular guy as our f of x, this problem has now reduced to finding out where the particular line f of x is going to cross the x axis. Okay. So that is the problem that we have reduced to, and then we will use this Taylor series expansion that I spoke about over here. So we will use this particular Taylor series expansion around any point A, and then we will try to find out how this particular Hinnon's algorithm is going to behave from a numerical perspective. Okay, we will do that in the fourth module, but the overall point is that each module that we are going to take is going to have essentially we are going to cover an analysis. Lot of it is going to be based on relatively simple problems, trying to analyze the particular method and try to see what does that particular method, what are those properties of that method, and so on and so forth. Okay, and that is what we are going to do in this particular course.